नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभा नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा। आज के सत्संग में मैं आप सभी सभी का प्रेम और आशीर्वाद के साथ स्वागत करता हूं। सभी भक्तों, शिष्यों, सन्यासियों, समाजियों का स्वागत है। आई वेलकम ऑल डिवोटीज, डिसाइपल्स, समाजीज, सत्संगीज सिटिंग विथ अस थ्रू नित्यानंद टीवी, लोटस न्यूज चैनल, साधना टीवी, टूबे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड, सिटी सिटिंग विथ अस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड थ्रू टूबे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग, कैलगरी अमरनाथ, कैलगरी आर यू एबल टू हियर मी? यस। बैंगलोर सिटी सेंटर, सियाटल चिदंबरम, ग्वाडलूप रामेश्वरम, फीनिक्स कांचीपुरम, ओहायो प्रयाग, लॉस एंजेलिस अरुणाचलम, ओक्लाहोमा सोमनाथम, सैन होसे मदुरै, सिंगापुर सिंगापुरम, नित्यानंद नगरम हैदराबाद, नित्यानंद नगर बैंगलूर, टोरंटो कैलासम, हांगकांग सीरगाड़ी वाशिंगटन डीसी, श्रीपुरम आस्टिन, शिकागो श्रीरंगम, न्यूयॉर्क वाराणसी, ह्यूस्टन कालाहस्ती, वेलिंगटन न्यूजीलैंड, बोगोटा कोलंबिया, रिचमंड हिल कनाडा, दुबई वैद्यनाथम, आदिनित्यानंद ध्यानपीठम, आवर्तिपालयम, सांता फे न्यू मेक्सिको, हैदराबाद, गुप्तकाशी, चार्लट, श्रीशैलम, कोलालंपुर, पड़नी, तिरुवान्मियूर, चेन्नई, टोरंटो, पोब्राज, स्लोवाकिया, ओमन, शिवगंगई, कोलराडो स्प्रिंग्स यूएसए, सैन डियागो, ओशन साइड, जोरपाटी, नेपाल, एनरिचिंग टेंपल, बिडदी, सैन एंटोनिया, टेक्सास, रिचमंड हिल कनाडा। यस, आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू विथ माय लव एंड रेस्पेक्ट्स। आई स्पेशली वेलकम ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स इन टोरंटो कैलासम, ऑल द डिवोटीज, व्यूवर्स, विजिटर्स गैदर्ड इन टोरंटो कैलासम फॉर स्पेशल कल्पतरु दर्शन, यूनिक कल्पतरु दर्शन, कल्पतरु उत्सव। ओ, द हॉल इज ओवरफ्लोइंग एंड पीपल आर इन द गर्भमंदिर आल्सो। ब्लेसिंग्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू। ग्रेट, आई थिंक फर्स्ट टाइम टेंपल इज ओवरफ्लोइंग। एंड टुडे द all the inner awakening participants, you guys are going to enjoy the world's oldest recorded ritual, Ganga Aarti. Please understand, see, when a priest completes the ritual and signs a document and receives his salary, that document is called maniyam. Maniyam is the name of the document. All Hindu temples boast their age, their oldness based on that maniyam record only. That record where the priest completes his ritual, signs and receives his salary, that record is accepted as a evidence to recognize the temple's oldness and unbroken worship. See, in Hindu tradition, size of the temple does not matter. How many number of years the worship has happened without breakage, without disturbance? So please understand, Sringeri temple has 1200 years of unbroken record. Rameshwaram temple has 1700 years of unbroken record. And Ganga Aarti has a record of 12,000 years. Understand? 12,000 years. More than 1,000 Kumbh Melas. Ganga Aarti has a record. It is unbroken ritual. The oldest ritual available to us with record is Ganga Aarti. Done in Arkipudi. Means the feet of Shiva. Where Ganga comes to wash the feet of Shiva. So, you are going to enjoy that ritual today on exactly the same spot. Of course, Vishwanath temple and all has long maniams, but broken in between. In between it was broken. Fortunately, even Madurai Meenakshi temple maniam is broken. It is not continuous. During the Muslim invasion, it was broken. And then the deity was smuggled into Adinam and puja was going on there. But in the temple itself, the maniam is broken. Some of Rameshwaram, because they are island, the army cannot go to Rameshwaram, you see. Army has to stop with Pamban. The army cannot go to Rameshwaram. So Rameshwaram was saved. So today you guys are going to enjoy the Arkipodi Aarti, worship of Mother Ganga. It is recorded from the ancient time immemorial. The oldest ritual I have seen in any scripture referred is Ganga Aarti only, Ganga's puja. Puja done to Ganga, Ganga Aarti. It may be very simple ritual. I can say it will be maximum half an hour only. The whole ritual is, but done without getting broken. One advantage is, say, a temple ritual, for example, Meenakshi temple ritual. If Madurai is captured, that ritual will be broken. If Rameshwaram is captured, that ritual will be broken. But Ganga, you can never capture the whole banks of Ganga. Only one part you can capture always. The other part will be free. At some corner, this priest will go and stand and perform the aarti. So that is the way the ritual was kept alive. It was an unbroken tradition. Because the deity is too big. It cannot be captured by any enemies or war or army. How will you capture from Gangotri to Ganga Sagar? Even if you capture from Gangotri to Ganga Sagar, we will be sitting in Tapovan and doing it. And Gomu can do it. Even if you capture, you can't keep an eye. That ritual is not done. All right. Today again I wanted to expand on Kalpataru. Listen. This is for the inner awakening participants also. Dhyan se suniye. Please listen. There is a big difference between every action you take with the idea of impossibility and with the idea of possibility. Understand? For example, from Haridwar you are traveling to Delhi. You are going by walk. Every step you take, you put with the idea you are never going to reach Delhi, with all kinds of doubts. Who knows whether this is the right road? Who knows whether the temper and the weather will be helping us? Who knows I will not get into some accident and die? With all kinds of doubts, the more and more number of steps you put, more and more you will be tired, sick, depressed. If you walk in the same road with the idea of possibility, more and more you will be excited. When you see every name board, wow, we are coming closer to Delhi, closer to Delhi. And the ideas, what you are going to achieve, enjoy, have in Delhi. That will inspire you and excite you more and more. Please understand, don't ever think like a so-called rationalists, irrational rationalists. These irrational rationalists always give an argument. What is there? Whether I believe or don't believe, the same number of steps only I have to take to reach Delhi. Understand? Number of steps may be same, but the effort will not be same. When you walk with the impossibility, number of steps may be same, but the effort will be more. If you walk with the possibility, number of steps may be same, but effort will be practically zero. The more and more action, the more and more excitement is the definition of possibility. The more and more action, more and more excitement. The more and more action, more and more tiredness and boredom is the definition of impossibility. One of my disciples asked me, Swamiji, what is this? Every day morning exactly you get up, run to take bath, do your puja. I'm sincerely doing. Even I am sometimes surprised. See, after the realization of my incarnationhood, see, from the age of 3, I started puja. First, I started with Ganapati puja, with the Ganesha deity I got. Then, a few deities added, but from the age of 3, I remember me doing puja unbroken till the age of 22, and after 22, no puja, and just being in the samadhi, that's all. Again, the day I took up the responsibility of Madhurayadinam, from that day till now, unbroken, I am doing puja as a tradition. I'll sit and invoke my own presence and offer. It will be very cute if you see the puja. I'll sit with so much of joy and I'll feel exactly almost like a my own hand putting it on myself. But it is such a joy. So one disciple asked me, what is this, Swamiji? You do your puja and run to the satsang. Are you going to do this for your whole life forever? Please understand, the moment he asked, I know that idea of boredom and tiredness as a pattern in him, immediately I told. First thing, understand, not only my whole life, even after I leave the body, I am going to be doing this. I am going to be doing this forever. As Aksharadhama. Forever and ever. From my Aksharadhama, I will continuously be available. You will see all over the world in all my samadhis. People will gather every morning, do Pada Puja and sit for Satsang, Upanishad with me. When I am in the body, when my body is moving and when my vocal cord is functioning, it is Satsang, Nitya Satsang. When that does not function, it is Nitya Upanishad, that's all. It is going to be my action whether I am in the body or after I leave the body. He could not understand. The disciple could not understand. I wanted to tell him and tell every one of you, if any action brings you tiredness and boredom, you already have a belief of impossibility. The subtle impossibility is already developed in you. I tell you, beauty in the action is possibility. We all know how to beautify our body and skin. We need to know how to beautify our actions. When you are carrying possibility and acting, every action brings more and more joy and excitement. You will grow younger and younger. Your face will become more graceful, more younger, more beautiful. Very rarely I have seen people growing younger. One person, without doubt, I can say, Satya Sai Baba. He grew younger and younger and younger. The more time passes, he was becoming more graceful and more younger. Without any controversy or doubt, I will tell very clearly and boldly. One person I have seen in my life, growing younger and younger and younger, is Satya Sai Baba. I have seen Yogi Ramaswara Kumar also. Not only the face and the being, even the lifestyle, everything. Bhagavan Ramaswara Kumar, the more the number of years, he became more like a child. He was growing younger. I tell you, the same Haridwar to Delhi, if you walk with the idea of impossibility, SDHD, you will not even cross Roorkee. Before that itself, in some Ganga canal, you may fall and die. With SDHD, you will not even cross Roorkee. if you walk the same road with the idea of possibility, without SDHD, every step gives you excitement. By the time you reach Delhi, you have all the excitement of Delhi, and you get excited to do more walking, more yatra. I tell you honestly, when I started my yatra, please understand, let it be on record. When I started my Parivrajak yatra, I never thought or planned I will walk length and breadth of India. I'll spend so much time in my Parivrajak yatra. The first few days of yatra, I carried with the idea of possibility, that's all. The concept of possibility gave me so much courage, so much joy. I never imagined I spent 9 full years. God. See, a person who is more awake, for him, one day is equivalent to the 3 days of a normal man. So even for the inner awakening, all the IA graduates understand, you guys did not go through 21-day program. You have gone through 63-day program in 21 days. Because the number of hours you are working, just see. Morning 4 o'clock you have to get up. Am I right? Sorry, 3. Because 4 you have to be in the yoga. 3 you have to get up and 4 you have to be here. From 3, what time you go to bed? 9 or 10? Sometime 11. In the normal, everyday, regular day, average a man works 6 to 7 hours a day. Here, come on, see how many hours. And that also, all the emotional roller coasters, ups and downs. And so much of cleansing. So, 3 days action you go through in one day. Understand? External cleaning. So, I was this kind of a person. Too many hours means many number of hours, waking hours. Too many number of waking hours was my lifestyle from the beginning. So, I never imagined 9 years. 9 means in my lifestyle, 9 into 4. 36 years. Because for me, there is no other thing. No waking, no dreaming and sleeping state. I never thought so many years I'll spend in Parivrajak Yatra. Now I remember, when I'm going around the Haridwar, I have not spent years in Haridwar, surely months only, at different time, but months only, not years. But I feel like as if I know the whole Haridwar, because I don't keep quiet. I'll be walking around everywhere, going to every temple, going to every ashram, going to every place. The active lifestyle, I tell you, because that possibility gave me the excitement. Only now when I look back, I am shocked 9 years I spent in Parivrajaka. Means going from place to place, not being stable in one place. God, please understand, take this one lesson, internalize this one truth. It may be same number of steps, same distance, but the effort, result, everything will be different if you carry possibility with you. I tell you, when you travel with possibility idea from Haridwar to Delhi with idea of possibility, even if you walk the same number of steps, you will forget many times you walked or you struggled so much. To tell you honestly, when I describe it, looks like a struggle for all of you, my Parivaraj Yatra time. Otherwise, it was simply honey sun. Travel in your life also with the possibility in your heart. You will see, one, every step does not tires you. It adds more and more excitement. See, when you walk with impossibility, every step adds anxiety, not excitement. When you walk with possibility, every step adds excitement. And when you reach the goal, you won't even feel tired that you did so much. Because when you are walking, you did not feel tired. See, when you are walking, if you did not feel tired, after reaching, you will not have the tiredness memory. But with the idea of impossibility, while you are walking, it will be tired. You may not reach. By mistake, if you reach, it will give you the idea of, oh, so much difficulty. I tell you, I don't feel at all I have struggled to do anything in my life. That's why still I don't care about all this opposition, abusal, illegal attacks. I'm not at all bothered. Actually, these guys who are abusing, spreading lies, spreading rumors, they should have a small trailer of my inner space. They should get to look into my inner space. They will really be, because they may be thinking I'm giving too much importance to them in my inner space. When they look there and they find they are not even there, they will really be upset. Because they really expect that I should be afraid of them, or I should be frightened about them, or I should have at least little concern. This is too much. What to do? I tell you one thing. I tell all these guys who are abusing us, attacking us, illegally, immorally, adharmically, and lying about us, spreading rumors. I wanted to tell all you guys one thing. Please understand. Do not fight with a man who don't have vengeance. Understand? This is a secret of life. I don't have any vengeance. I don't have any violence. My inner space is full of power. Don't fight with the guy who don't have vengeance. You will fall and collapse, fail bitterly. See, only a person with vengeance will become tired, will become bored, will feel he is doing so much. A person without vengeance will never feel he is doing too much. I neither feel I am doing too much, nor I have any vengeance against anybody. Or I have anger, no, nothing. Understand? one of the very important lessons in the life. Do not fight with a guy who don't have vengeance. You will lose the game. Always fight with a fellow who has a vengeance. You will always win the game. Please understand. The fellow with vengeance, even if he's a too big guy, you are a too small guy, you just go with the space of without vengeance, go with the completion, you will just win him. I am still working and trying to get some of the Akashic records. How did the few Akkada sadhus fail in the war? I want to study because many of our Akkada sadhus were established on Nididhyasana. Only after they were established on Nididhyasana level, means the cognitive shift has happened, they have sent to war, they have been sent to war. How did they, few wars they lost, how did they lose? I want to study. Maybe before some emergency, I think some of the people have been sent to war before the training. That might have been the reason for their loss. Otherwise, I tell you, a violence-free man can never be conquered. It's the law of life. Violence-free man can never be conquered. My victory declares not just my victory, victory of Dharma. I am telling you, my victory over all these abusive elements, anti-spiritual elements, anti-social elements, anti-humanity elements, anti-national elements, proves this one truth. A non-violent person can never be conquered. You will always lose if you are fighting with a non-violent person. Because he is so powerful. I tell you, a non-violent person will be so powerful inside, he will not have any wound inside. And he knows very beautifully he will handle the whole situation. And he knows what to do. When you are filled with violence, you will not know what to do. You will enter foolishly into small ashram and break, beat that Swami and get into trouble. I tell you, that is why in tradition, always before war, warrior has to do tapas. He has to do tapas. Whether it is Arjuna or Bhima, first they have to do tapas, become non-violent, powerful, only then any war. I tell you, carry this space of possibility, you will always win in all wars. No one can win you in any war. Because the space of possibility excites you more and more, inspires you more and more, brings rejoice in you. You can see in my life, really people thought, how can Swamiji do 21 day program continuously? First year we did 1, second year we did 2, third year we did 4, fourth year we did 6, sorry, third year we did one because of the abusal and attack. But fourth year we did six, four. And fifth year we did six. Sixth year we did eight. And seventh year we are doing 12. Yes, 2008-1, 2009-2, 2010 because of the attack and abusal, 1, 2011-4, 2012-6, 2013-8, now 2014-12. It's only just multiplying. By next year, I am training acharyas. I'll do in one spot, acharyas will be going around and doing in different places. Understand? Carry the space of possibility. Every day action will only lead you to more and more excitement. Every inner awakening only excites me, not tires me. I am only excited to spend more time with people, to be with people. Everyday Kalpataru only excites me, doesn't tires me. I tell you, in your life, carrying the space of possibility in your heart is Kalpataru. So meditate on this one truth. Carrying the space of possibility in your heart is Kalpataru. Essence of today's satsang is this one line. Carrying the space of possibility in your heart is Kalpataru.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share and explore in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore. 562-109. Contact 0974220331. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.